Dear sewing friends, I'm really happy to see your beautiful faces, and my hope, my true goal for today is that after this video, all of us are gonna take a huge step towards better sewing, not only throughout this year, but hopefully in the long run as well. And you know, we're gonna start with quite an unpleasant conversation, which is a conversation about bad habits. And I say quite unpleasant because, well, let's face it, nobody really wants to talk about bad habits, but tough. We're doing it today. And one of the reasons why it really is near and dear to my heart, because I, number one, see this as a reoccurring theme in your comments when I read them underneath my videos. And number two is because, of course, I am just like you and I've been there. I still end up sometimes with these bad habits. We're all people, we tend to fall into the old traps. So I truly hope that my two cents will help you today. And this first one doesn't come as a big surprise. So let's jump right into it. All right, I'm gonna read you some real snippets from real comments from you guys so that way you will understand a little bit better. Hopefully you can relate as well. So Francis says, I'm too intimidated. And then Cindy says, I'm just scared it might go wrong, so I haven't sewed any clothes. And Michelle says, and listen to this one really carefully, she says, the fear of failing, of wasting energy and resources have kept me from this craft for decades. And to this craft, she refers to sewing. And what do I tell you guys in almost every single video that I do in my channel? And I say it with full conviction and belief that if I can do it, then you can do it as well. And I say it for a reason, to boost your confidence. But at the end of the day, the truth is, I can say it all day long, but if you don't believe in yourself, if you don't find that spark that, you know what, today is the day, let's do it, I believe I can at least start. You don't have to believe that you're going to be the next top designer, but you have to believe in yourself enough to start. And that is one of the really bad habits that I see too often for my taste, really, is that you just don't believe in yourself. You know, fake it until you make it if you have to. I can't reach through the computer screen, grab you by the hand and say, okay, you know what, let's do it together. I would love to, but I can't. So you have to believe in yourself above anything else, that you can start, that you can practice, that you can achieve something. Start small as always and then progress with time, but start believing in yourself. Now, another really quick point to add to the topic of believing in yourself is that if you don't do it, nobody else will. So if you really want to sew, if you really want to draft patterns, if you really want to cook, to paint, or to do whatever else, you gotta do it, because if you won't, nobody else will, right? Okay, so that is actually half the trouble. I also see a lot of fear in your comments, right? Fear of cutting into your beautiful fabric and ruining it. Fear of pattern drafting and what if it doesn't fit? Fear of taking your own measurements. Fear of your sewing machine. Fear of trying a new technique. And in my experience and in my opinion, a lot of that fear, and not only in sewing but also in life, comes from the unknown and from one really bad sewing habit that I find that I also sometimes do, and I see that quite a bit, and that is not doing a test garment, not doing a mock-up or a trial or a muslin, you call it however you want, but not doing that step will cause you more anxiety and more stress than it actually should. And I think that spending 30 minutes on actually making a muslin will relieve you of all of that stress and all of that anxiety and all of that pulling your hair out, then staring at your beautiful fabric for 2.5 hours thinking to cut or not to cut, to try or not to try, to chance it or not to chance it, right? And then you just turn around, walk away, and your idea, your creation never actually comes to life. But you don't have to sew out the actual full garment. You're just piecing it together to check the fit, to check the style, to check the design elements, to see if what you have actually envisioned in here transforms into a 3D form and looks really good on you, or maybe not, maybe you need to tweak it here and there before you proceed onto your actual good fabric and cutting it out. And then once you know that, aha, this is amazing, then you can take your great fabric, cut with confidence, without stress, without hesitation, knowing that you're already halfway there. Needless to say, I'm a huge advocate for doing your test garments or your test patterns. Now, do I do them every single time? No, not necessarily. If I've done this design for years or maybe 20 times or over, and I know my measurements, I know how it's going to fit, I know how it's going to look, or at least I can project that, then I don't do a test garment. However, for example, let's say I'm working with a woven bodice block, darted bodice block, and I want to transform it into a princess seam block. Yes, I will do a mock-up of that to see if the placement of the princess seams is where I want them to be, if it looks flattering for the design that I have in my mind, if it looks flattering for the fabric that I chose or will be choosing for this project. So of course, and we will be talking about this in a future video, so definitely stay tuned, but please don't skip transforming this bad habit into a good sewing habit of doing your test garments. Now, this one is actually really sad because I'm still dealing with the consequences of this one really bad sewing habit that I had when I first started sewing years ago. Now, I still do it from time to time because I think that we could all benefit from a spontaneous decision once in a while, especially when it comes to a creative hobby like sewing. But this really bad sewing habit of purchasing sewing supplies and sewing garments without a plan in sight really got me into a place where I wasn't happy with my hobby at all. And years ago, what I did was, everything was so fun and exciting, and it still is, but sewing was really new, really fresh hobby for me. So I would go and I would just buy anything that looked fun and interesting and good, including fabric, sewing notions, magazines, sewing books, sewing supplies, you name it. Same went for the sewing of my garments, right? Anything that looked appealing on Instagram, anything that looked really fun and interesting, there I was sewing it. And what it really did, A, it accumulated a huge stash of things that I don't need, or maybe I do need, but I can't possibly use them within the next 5 to 10 years because I have so many zippers, anybody? And then it also turned my closet, which was pretty curated at the time because I was working a very specific job with a very specific dress code, into an assortment of different things that kind of were out of place, and I never really wore them again because I just sewed them without a plan. So definitely stay away from this really bad sewing habit. I do think that, in my opinion, it is a bad one. You might like to go with the flow and just kind of do whatever makes you happy in the moment, which is great. I know that I benefit and that I definitely thrive when there is a plan in mind, or at least a general direction in which I would like to go, because then it ensures that I don't spend more money on fabric that I will not use or that will sit on the shelf for years, that I will fall out of love, that will go out of style or whatever else. And that also will ensure that the garment that I'm going to make is actually going to get all of that use and all of that wear. So that way I feel really great for investing all of that time and all of that energy in making it in the first place. So definitely I would say sticking to a plan or having a plan definitely helps. Now, this one can go both ways. It can be really good and beneficial, and it can also be really bad and toxic. So we're gonna be talking about the toxic one. And the really bad habit that I think really paralyzes a lot of us is comparing yourselves to others. And one of the reasons why I say that it can actually be really good and beneficial is because, let's say I am talking about how to do a rolled hem manually on a sewing machine without a rolled hem foot, but somebody has a different technique how to achieve the same result but in a different way. Comparing ourselves is really great and beneficial because then we can learn something. Now, the point where comparing ourselves to others turns really toxic is when we actually forget that each one of us is completely different. We all learn differently, some hands-on, some visual learners, some need repeating 5 times. Like, for example, me, I remember when I was training for different jobs, I would tell my trainer that, you know what, I will ask you about this probably a couple of times, you will need to show it to me hands-on about 3 to 4, sometimes 5 times, but I promise once I get it, I get it, I will not ask you again. So you see, everybody is different, so don't compare your beginning to somebody else's middle or finish line, because it's so easy to get discouraged. You see your result when you're just making first steps, and you see somebody else's result after 10 years of constant practice and doing this thing over and over and over again, of course the result is going to be different, but we tend to forget that. So we compare the result without looking back at the journey, and it discourages us to the core. Then we start forgetting that, you know what, we need to believe in ourselves in order to succeed and to move forward, and that's it. And we fall into that trap deep, 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 deep until we lose all interest in our hobbies. Now, this might have been a little bit different than you would have expected from a video like this, but I truly hope that it gave you some food for thought, that courage, that boost that you needed to keep going at sewing and to really make this the best year of sewing that it could possibly be for you. Now, if you want to learn more about how to set your sewing goals so that you really achieve them, go ahead and click on the video right over here. And until next time, happy, thoughtful, and creative sewing. I'll see you soon. Bye.